Electric motors are everywhere. In your house, almost every mechanical movement that you see around you is caused by an AC, alternating current, or DC, direct current, electric motor. Starting in the kitchen, there are motors in the fan over the stove and in the microwave oven, the blender, the refrigerator, two or three in fact, one for the compressor, one for the fan inside the refrigerator, as well as one in the ice maker. The stand mixer. In the utility room, there is an electric motor in the dryer, the electric screwdriver, the vacuum cleaner, the electric drill, the furnace blower. Even in the bathroom, there's a motor in the fan, the electric toothbrush, the hair dryer, the electric razor. By understanding how a motor works, you can learn a lot about magnets, electromagnets, and electricity in general. An electric motor uses magnets to create motion. If you have ever played with magnets, you know about the fundamental law of all magnets. Opposites attract and likes repel. So, if you have two bars magnets with their ends marked north and south, then the north end of one magnet will attract the south end of the other. On the other hand, the north end of one magnet will repel the north end of the other, and south will repel south. Inside an electric motor, these attracting and repelling forces create rotational motion. The outside of a DC motor is the stator, a permanent magnet that does not move. The inside part is the rotor, which does move. The rotor here is like the nail in our previous example, and the stator is like the horseshoe magnet. When DC power is sent through the rotor, it creates a temporary electromagnetic field that interacts with the permanent magnetic field of the stator. The commutator's job is to keep the polarity of the field flipping, which keeps the rotor rotating. This creates the torque needed to produce mechanical power. The winding of the stator in an AC motor kind of does the job of the rotor of a DC motor. In this case, it's a ring of electromagnets that are paired up and energized in sequence, which creates the rotating magnetic field. You'll remember that the rotor in a DC motor is hooked up to the battery. But the rotor in an AC motor does not have any direct connection to a power source. Nor does it have brushes. Instead, it often uses something called a squirrel cage. An AC motor or alternating current motor is an electric motor that consists of a stator with a coil that is supplied with alternating current to convert electric current into mechanical power. The stator is the stationary part of the motor while the rotor is the rotating part. AC motors can be single or three-phase, with three-phase motors mainly used for bulk power conversion. Single-phase AC motors are used for small power conversions. There are two types of AC motors, which are synchronous and induction. In a synchronous motor, the rotation of the shaft is at the same pace as the frequency of the applied current, with multiphase AC electromagnets on the stator that produce a rotating magnetic field. An induction motor, or asynchronous motor, is a single excited motor where current is applied to one part of the motor, the stator. Flux from the stator cuts the short-circuited coil in the rotor, which feels torque that makes the rotor rotate. The stator produces a rotating magnetic field. It has a solid metal axle, a loop of wire, coils, squirrel cage, and interconnections. Though a squirrel cage is not found in all AC motors, it is the most common type. In AC motors, electricity is sent directly to the outer coils of the stator. The stator has multiple plates that extend out from its center with copper magnetic wire.